o'clock, the Texans. The Baltimore Ravens now on the clock. It's the Cowboys now on the clock. Next up, the Patriots are on the clock. With the next selection, it's the Washington Commanders. Now we turn to the Eagles. They're on the clock. The Seattle Seahawks are now on the clock. It's the Philadelphia Eagles now on the clock. And now on the clock, the Minnesota Vikings. The Cincinnati Bengals are on the clock. It's the Bucks now on the clock. The Jaguars are on the clock now. Next up, it's the Packers on the clock. The Chargers are up now. They're on the clock. with the next pick. The Miami Dolphins are on the clock. The Kansas City Chiefs, now on the clock. On the clock now, the Houston Texans. Next up, it's the Dolphins on the clock. With the next selection, the Falcons are on the clock. Next up, it's the Seahawks on the clock. The Pittsburgh Steelers on the clock now. It's the Detroit Lions now on the clock. And now on the clock, it's the Arizona Cardinals. It's the Bills now on the clock. The Chicago Bears are on the clock now. The Las Vegas Raiders are on the clock. The Colts, now on the clock. The Detroit Lions, now on the clock. It's the Carolina Panthers, now on the clock. With the next pick, The Raiders are on the clock. The Indianapolis Colts are now on the clock. The Houston Texans are now on the clock. Now on the clock, it's the Las Vegas Raiders. The Denver Broncos are now on the clock.
This player has a zone ability. This is a powerful ability that can be activated when the player completes in-game objectives. Only X-Factor players have zone abilities. Welcome to week one of the NFL preseason, where the rookies of today hope to become the stars of tomorrow. It's the Raiders and the Vikings, and it's coming up next on EA Sports.
And we find ourselves at the stadium that played host to Super Bowl 52, the wondrous U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. Tonight, we kick off the preseason with a good matchup right away between the Las Vegas Raiders and the Minnesota Vikings. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, and we finally made it, partner, through the winter, through the spring, now into the summer, and football finally back.
And during that time off, we all cherish our vacation time. But admit it, you're the same as me. When you were working out, when you were doing things, you thought about football, didn't you? And you couldn't wait to be back up here again.
So they'll bring it out to the 25. So here's the Viking offense making their way out. They'll be led out by a former Pro Bowl quarterback out of the University of Georgia, Matthew Stafford.
And Matthew Stafford was taken first overall in the 2009 draft, and he certainly played like a top pick. Throughout his career, he's been one of the most prolific passers in the league, and there's no reason to believe he's going to slow down his production anytime soon. Not only that, he's also one of the tougher quarterbacks in the league as well.
Right to the air. Here's Stafford. Man open. That's Deebo Samuel. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. An early statement on the game's first play. 18 yards and a first down.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. A first carry now. This is Alvin Kamara. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. They run it again with Kamara. And this one not going anywhere. They get him at the 44 for a gain of just a yard. J.J. Watt on the tackle. Throwing on third down, Stafford. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to. And Cook now on to punt as he gets this one away. And great special teams work here. This is knocking on the door of the five. They'll spot it at the 6-yard line.
A Someone's going to be happy with that effort. You know who else is going to be happy? His defense.
Absolutely.
He's created a very long field for that offense to try to traverse.
And he got some help from Mr. Football there, checking up nicely. Good English on that punt. So the Raiders backed up here to begin their first drive. And they will be led out by their rookie quarterback.
So this is what we find out about the game plan and the trust factor, don't we? In this situation, the natural thing is take care of the ball. Run it inside. Everyone cover it. Just, you know, get yourself some room and let your punter punt it out of there. But when you really got a QB you can trust, you might want to take a little shot early and try to create some space.
They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Handoff up the middle. Hunt. And yet again, he's stopped behind the line of scrimmage. Great job by this Vikings defense. That'll wind up as a loss on the play, so now they're staring at a third down and 12.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
On third down, here's Hunt. And he gets it up to the 10-yard line here. A good pickup there, 7 yards. Did a great job for the end. So opening drive, three straight runs, unable to pick up the first.
I know the fans want to see first downs, but guess what? The coaches have reasons for what they're doing. Sometimes they've scripted it. And some of these runs, while they haven't been successful now, they may be successful later on.
Here's A.J. Cole now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. Returnable here from the 38. 6-yard return after a punt of 48. And the Vikings will take over here, first and 10. The Vikings taking the field here for their second drive of the game. Defense got the better of them last series, forcing a punt. See if they make a few changes in the game plan here and try to get points out of this drive. First and 10. And this will be taken across midfield and into Raider territory.
He's across midfield to the 49-yard line.
Second down, and it's Kamara again. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
First and 10 at the 46-yard line.
Again, it's Kamara. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Kamara up the middle. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Talk about good down and distance, allowing offenses to expand their playbook. A second and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And he stopped immediately there.
Holding offense.
They're backed up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty. They'll pound it up the middle with Kamara. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. We're scoreless after one. Second quarter now from Minnesota. It's the Vikings in possession of the football. Ball at the 33, second and 9. And now a first chance for the backup here to throw. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. Dio Odengbo. Credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of six.
They've gobbled up over 30 yards of turf so far, but a sack knocks them backwards, and that interrupts the momentum they were building. Good opportunity for the defense to escape this drive before they get to the end zone.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. To throw, Huntley. This one caught by his tight end, Oliver. And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35.
Excellent job there defensively. Gave up the underneath to the tight end on third down, and they made sure that they did their job. Got him on the ground and prevented him picking up a first down.
Now the Vikings will send out the special teams crew here for a field goal try. From the right hash, this from 53. And I don't think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good. And this will remain a scoreless game.
Still searching for that first breakthrough, and I thought this might be it. But it's not to be, and we're still scoreless.
Thanks for the lurk. I appreciate it.
Coming up for this Las Vegas offense. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least two first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
Well, that is a running back who was not about to go down easily. He fought his way through the contact until the seas opened up for him.
And with a guy his size, you have to know defensively that arm tackles aren't going to fly with him. You have to be able to wrap up, or else he can just brush tacklers aside like they're not even there.
First down, they'll stick with Haskins. Gets past one man. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 16 more on that one and another first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went three and out.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Five yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. And they'll keep leaning on the running game. Back to the ground. And the Raiders are going to have a first and goal as he's able to take this inside the 10 to the 8.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. Four plays, three first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. Here we go now on first and goal. They'll run here with Haskins. It'll be a pickup of four, and it brings up second and goal. They go play action now. Ryan. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth. Tucker's kick is good. And the Raiders jump out to a 3-0 advantage. So after drive number three here, we have a score, and it's 3 points after the field goal.
I would say the feeling out process for both of these teams, I'd say it's over, partner. Everyone understands what's going on now. You've kind of probed a little bit. Now you want to start throwing the big shots. First 3 points up on the board could be significant.
And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 20. Here's Huntley. And incomplete, he dropped it. Maybe a rookie mistake there. Second down. Huntley to throw. They'll get this underneath to Madison. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth,
yes,
and he's
I
miles
am.
Away and smiling.
And happy.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. Following the punt return here, there's someone shaken up. Well, injury's never good, especially here in the preseason. Hopefully nothing serious. They'll take a look at him, and we'll step aside for a moment. On first down, Ryan. Check down complete to Haskins. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. Throwing again on second down. Ryan over the middle. That's caught by Schwartz. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Now it's Ryan. And this is caught. It's Parker. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Ryan. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. To throw again on second down. Ryan. And incomplete.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here, because any completions on first and second down, now you got to worry a little bit about the clock, because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. But if you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
And he gets this early to the 41. Not near enough for the first. That's going to bring up fourth down. Only a gain of 2 there.
How about that strategy there, Brandon? Third down. They just said, we got faith in our tacklers. We'll give you the short stuff. And just decided to protect the sticks. So every time I hear fans telling me tackling's not a part of the game anymore, plays like that, I can clip and save and show them you have to tackle well if you want to be a good defense.
And he missed it. It's no good. And that will keep this a 3-point game. So we have reached halftime in our first preseason matchup of the year. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thank you very much. Back to you guys in just a minute as we've started the countdown to opening night. Remember, the preseason has shrunk from 4 games down to 3. So just 2 more weeks of preseason action follow this, and then we get it all started on the first Thursday after Labor Day. Meanwhile, for the Vikings, we check on their numbers on the ground in the first half, as they know they'll need to be better to overcome this halftime deficit.
Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. It is fielded right at the goal line. And he will make it back to the 15, and that's it. Good coverage there by the kick team. Now comes the Raiders offense. They'll go on offense first to start quarter number 3. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what do we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Now it's Ryan. Hard throw, incomplete. Second drop indeed. Not a good look. Forty-two-yard punt, 6 on the return. And it will be Vikings ball, 1st and 10. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally, because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
Yeah, they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal. And he'll take this beyond the line of scrimmage as he slides to a hole. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. To throw on third down, Huntley eluding the pressure right. And he nearly got the first himself, but it appears he's going to be about a yard or two short. So the completion good for 6 yards, and that'll bring up fourth down.
He thought he might take a shot down the field, but instead they're on a drag. Run away from the defender, but a really good job keeping the play in front of them, and they force a fourth down.
Here's Logan Cook now as he's on to punt for Minnesota. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And this will be out of bounds at the what here? The 12-yard line. And now this offense comes back out onto the field. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is, can you gain an advantage in field position? And that's what both teams are seeking right now.
Yeah, they'll be seeking to gain that advantage here on this drive. To throw again on second down, Ryan. Had his hands on it, but dropped it. The rookie making a little bit of a rookie mistake. Third down. Haskins trying to pick it up. That he won't get close. Only a yard. 4th and 3.
This was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass. But that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football. They just swarmed and stopped them for almost no game.
Here's A.J. Cole now as he's on to punt for Las Vegas. He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. We'll call that a 49-yard punt with a return of just 2. And it will be 1st and 10 as they take over. Now the Vikings offense gets set to take over here. And, Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the first half. Now that their defense has done its job, it's their turn now to go out and try and get some points.
He's able to force his way through one man, but he can muster only about a yard on the play. 2nd down. Operating from the gun. Huntley, that's going to be caught by Colton. So back-to-back plays each get nothing, and that's going to set up a tough 3rd and 9. Looking to throw, Huntley. Finding a safety valve here, that's complete. And this play going to be stopped in its tracks at the 32, and obviously well short of the first down. They'll get only a yard out of that, and it'll bring up 4th down.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Elsewhere at Arrowhead there in the third quarter. Now you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Patrick Mahomes leading the way offensively. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And, Charles, we've seen almost 3 full quarters now, and neither offense offense can really get it going. Neither has hit the end zone, and neither side seemingly can make that big play.
But the game hasn't been devoid of action because these two defenses, they've taken over and they've slugged it out. But I think you're exactly right. We're at that stage of the game now where one of these offenses, if they make a big play, that could be the difference.
Now Ryan. He's going to let one go deep for Parker. And that's caught inside the 35. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. A great play there. 78 yards. And the Raiders use the big play to extend their fourth quarter lead. So obviously they will decline the penalty there, and the result is 6 points. Tucker with the extra point, and the lead grows to 10-0. Pretty clean and simple there. Just two plays, the long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number two. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
From the end zone, it's Dearness Johnson.
And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. The Vikings ready to go again on offense. And you're still in this game. I mean, yeah, you haven't scored. Offense obviously has struggled, but you're only two scores down, so all hope not lost.
Not at all, because we're talking about the NFL, and teams can score fast in this league. Quick strikes, you're right back in it. You're exactly right, keeping hope alive.
And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 11, he goes down. Not what they had in mind there. That's going to go as a loss of four.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown. To throw on second down. Huntley, he finds his man complete. That's Alexander. The offense on third down tonight, a pretty woeful 0-for-5 thus far. This will be third and five. Back to throw. Huntley buying time to his... And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. It'll be a loss of 8 on the sack, and it's going to lead him to fourth down. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's a really difficult task.
Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Vikings unable to convert here on fourth. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. So they really needed points here in a two-score game. Could not come away with anything there on fourth.
And while we know they're a little bit discouraged here, they can't check out of this game. You and I have called a good number of games over the course of our career where we've seen these types of situations. Teams get the ball back, and that miracle does occur. So they can't let that dream go just yet. They have to get stout on defense here.
Yeah, right now, really hoping for a turnover. He pushes through a would-be tackler to get about 3 yards, second down. To throw is Ryan. This will be caught at about the 5. That leads us to a first and goal. It's a pickup of 8.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. Haskins diving for the end zone, and he'll get there. Touchdown. An important score there, CD, and now an important extra point because it would make it a 3-score game.
Love the math there, and at this point in the fourth quarter, look, we all need next-gen stats, right? We all use them, but we don't need them here, do we? Because that means it's almost a certain victory.
Tucker now to add the point after. He's got it, and it's 17-0. So they only needed three plays on that drive.
And it was capped off by a touchdown run from Hassan Haskins.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
Taking it about the one.
Johnson now returning.
And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further.
The Vikings offense now, they get ready to head back on the field.
And certainly this, not the performance that they were hoping for to begin the exhibition season, but still plenty to watch for in this fourth quarter.
Throwing to start the drive, Huntley.
He's going up top for Taylor, and this is incomplete. Oh, he looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And his throw is incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10.
Brings up a third down.
Looking to throw, Huntley.
And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive.
He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted.
Vernon Hargraves with a pick. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Raider defense delivers a score. Little choice, Charles, but to go for it right there, and that pick six will be the icing on the cake.
Yeah, you don't know how many more possessions you're going to get, so really, you're almost at the point of no option. Have to go for it. Bottom line, though, is defenders know that as well. They know you've got to throw the football. Had the right defense call, it will make a nice play on the ball, and that's all she wrote.
Now Tucker to add the PAT. And the lead is now 24. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six.
Johnson won't return this, and the football will come out to the 25.
And now out comes Minnesota.
Well, it's been a struggle so far for this offense, Charles. It's not only that they haven't been able to put the points up, but really stringing yards together has been a real issue for them in this one.
I'm so glad you brought up the yardage, because I was thinking to myself, we've seen a lot of NFL games, and we've seen our share of lopsided contests, but in almost all of them, both offenses have put up at least 200 yards in a game, but not in this one. This has been a display of offense that, frankly, I think the two of us have watched from behind our hands, trying to spread our fingers wide enough to actually see the result.
After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Back to throw, Huntley. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And down he'll go at the 25. Give him 9 yards on the second down screen play. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. And the Raiders call on a nickel set for third down. Operating from the gun, Huntley. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds, so a big call there. That brings up fourth. On fourth down, Huntley. Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and incomplete on the deep ball. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Raiders with the football now in excellent field position. So they tried to go for it for pride, but it really wouldn't have mattered. This one, it was already determined.
No doubt about it. This one was over a while ago.
The Raiders heading out to take over. They lead big. Quite the kickoff, really, to this exhibition schedule as they start once more with a first and 10. Haskins now on first and 10.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Second down, and they go back to Haskins.
And still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
On third down, here's Haskins. And he'll be tackled about 2 yards shy of the line to gain. A 1 yard pickup leads to fourth down. Just a 1 yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down. And well, they could just run this clock out, but here is the field goal unit on fourth down. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through, and the lead increases even further. It's 27 to nothing now.
So this one, a victory for the Las Vegas Raiders.
And this was truly a total team effort, Charles, on both sides of the ball.
So they absolutely pitched a shutout, so it can't get much better than that, right? The defense led the way, but the offense did their part as well. They moved the ball up and down the field. So you've got to like what you saw. What do they call that, a total team effort? I think when it's time to hand out game balls, guys from both sides will end up getting one.
Justin Tucker set to boom this one away. And off we go from Soldier Field.
Out of the end zone comes Johnson.
So here are the Bears now for their opening drive.
They're led out by a former number two overall pick in the draft from BYU, Zach Wilson.
And we all know the scouting report on him. He can attack the field at all levels with a very strong arm and make big-time plays off schedule. We also see a player with confidence and swagger. We see a guy who knows how to lead a team, who knows how to compete.
First play, and Wilson wants to throw it.
Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And that's caught inside the 35.
And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35. Quite a show of arm strength right there. That was in the air for a long time, and it was on target, too.
And that's how you start a drive, because you know they had this play in their back pocket, waiting for the right time to unleash it. And boy, did they pick the right opportunity. Unleashed it big time, and that was also a big time throw.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Now it's Wilson.
And he's got his man on the out route.
And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27. They'll go option on second down, right side. And he is going to lose yardage here. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. Here's Wilson.
Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And oh, he's just going to be short here. Barely. Maybe by a half a foot. It'll be 4th and inches.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
Needing the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And just good downhill running there as he'll take this to the 15-yard line.
That's a fourth down pickup of 10 yards and an opportunity certainly missed on the defensive side. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script, you go through your play calling, you go through all the stuff and establish things, and it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
So this offense able to convert on fourth, and now a fresh set of downs here, 1st and 10.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. On in tape, a 15-yard touchdown grab.
And the Bears put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead.
And the QB rating right now, sky high. 4 for 4 on that opening drive, and it ends with a touchdown pass.
Yeah, I don't know quite how to figure it out. I think I need my friends from MIT to come in and help me. I think 158.3 is the number one.
No, that's
right? That's the highest you can get. That's where he is. He'd like to continue on that pace.
Extra point splits the uprights, and that makes the score 7-0. That time, a 6-play drive. And a touchdown for Chicago. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line.
So now it's the Raiders' turn to go on offense for the first time. And they will be led out by a guy certainly still trying to prove himself here in the league, the young rookie quarterback.
I tell you what, when he's on schedule for that week, secondaries take notice, because you've got to stay alert back there on every snap. A truly powerful arm, one is capable of challenging any level of the defense.
First carry now, and oh, right away he lost the football, and this is picked up by the Bears, and his guys will take over at the 30-yard line.
No coach or team's ever happy when someone has a turnover, but if there's ever a good time to do it,
preseason.
Yeah, right now. You know that come regular season, he's going to be ready to go. And maybe he'll remember, I don't want to do this when it comes time for the games to count.
Chicago works their way back onto the field here for their second. First down, Diggs, and he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of five. The first down run got five. Here's second and five. Throwing is Wilson. He'll get this out wide to Singletary. And he's going to be taken down. Plus, there's a penalty flag in the backfield. They may get 15 more on top of this. So the call there, roughing the passer.
Well, the preseason's time for working out the kinks, but sometimes you've got some defenders who are too eager to impress trying to make this team. And that time we saw one take a shot at the quarterback way too late.
Play action. Now Wilson. Flush to his right. And he's just going to throw this one out of bounds here. Nowhere to go with it. Incomplete. They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal. Up the middle they go. Diggs, and he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Well, they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is 3rd and goal from the shotgun. Wilson to the goal line, but it's incomplete. Now we've got a field goal coming up here for Chicago. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And his kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further. So the fumble recovery had set up at position, but they can muster only 3 points out of it.
Yeah, when you're able to force turnovers, especially with the results of field position like they had, you really want to make it hurt. Here, they take the field goal. That's definitely not what they were hoping for.
Fields it right around the goal line. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. Kareem Hunt and the rest of the offense making their way back out there. He's got to clear his mind a little bit right now. One carry, and that carry was a loss. Play fake here on first down. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. They'll run with Hunt on second down. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down. Well, you're down early. How do you get back in the game? Maybe establish the run. I think they're trying to do that.
Now I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offense coordinator, let's run the football, let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. And hold on here, because on that last run, it looks like we have a player who was shaken up. Boy, you hate to see this before the regular season even begins. We'll take a break and come back. More preseason action in a moment. Looking to throw on second down. Burns. He's got Cook running his slant. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line.
You can almost hear the sigh of relief coming from their sideline and from their point on the field, because this has been a tough start for them thus far. A much-needed first down there. They needed something good to happen. Plays like that will continue to help them dig out of this hole.
So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Hunt will try going up the middle, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up. 10-0 the score after one on EA Sports. Second quarter now, and it's Las Vegas with the football as they've got a second and 8 forthcoming. Looking to throw. Burns over the middle, complete. It's Anderson. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 32-yard line. That'll be a pickup of 10 as they try to recover from this 10-point deficit.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
On first down, they'll run with Hunt. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down. To throw on second down. Burns. Catch is made by Hunter Renfrow. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears 18. 11 more yards there, and this methodical drive continues.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And complete right side to Cook. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line. Looking to throw on second down. Burns, hauled in by Anderson, left side. And he's brought down. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, he just need the tip of the ball to cross the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with first and goal.
Hunt. Oh, he's going absolutely nowhere as he is hit behind the line. A full 5 yard loss that time. It's going to make second down pretty tough.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
Back at the 5 yard line now, second and goal. Back to throw. Burns, and he is going to go down, back at the 11-yard line. Marlon Davidson, credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of 6.
Second goal, last thing you need to do is get pushed backwards to take a sack, but he couldn't find anywhere to go with the football, had to eat it, and ended up on the ground.
They need to reverse the trend. The last two plays have gone backwards. Now it's third and goal. Looking to throw. Burns. To the end zone, but knocked away and incomplete. Tucker's kick is good. And they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3. So from an offensive perspective, at least able to get on the board here right in front of the two-minute warning.
Yeah, now it's time to talk about complimentary football, isn't it? Because if the defense can force a three and out, there could be enough time on the clock to then get the ball back for their offensive guys and maybe put some more points on the board before the half.
And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. The Bears offense now getting ready to take over. Their drive last time. They'll throw on first down with Wilson. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27. Now we're going to get a stoppage. Appears to be an injured Bear on the field.
Well, injury's never good, especially here in the preseason. Hopefully nothing serious. They'll take a look at him, and we'll step aside for a moment.
Operating from the 27 now. Here's 2nd and 3. On the jet sweep, this is Johnson. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Call a no gain that time, as it's going to leave him with a 3rd and about 3 to go.
Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first.
Wilson now to throw on 3rd down. Middle of the field, and the ball is knocked out. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
Now the Vegas offense heading back out there. And now they start.
Following the fumble recovery, Burns forced out to his left. He rifles one that's intercepted. And now off to the races, down the right side. And they will score a pick six for a Bears touchdown.
Well, CD, that's a huge play by this defense in a close ball game. I think he was trying to just extend the play there, getting outside the pocket, but he throws a costly pick six.
Yeah, he's trying to find someone open. You're exactly right. He wasn't looking to run. He was looking to throw. The result, not good for him. They were more than happy.
Here for the extra point. It's up and good, and that makes it 17-3. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25.
The Vegas offense ready for their next possession. It's been very much a slow start for them.
Throwing after the interception, Burns into the hands of his receiver, Anderson. And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8. Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. After the incompletion, here now, 3rd and 2. Found his target, it's Anderson.
And he is going to have the Raiders' first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And he'll go down. The Bears get there for the sack. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half.
Cook makes the catch on the out route.
Now another timeout called for by the offense. As the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in half number one.
And that's complete to Swain. And he is going to have the Raiders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. Operating from the gun, Burns.
He'll get this one underneath to Hunt. And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35.
Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get him with 10 seconds to go before halftime. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
Out of the end zone comes Johnson.
All that remains is to snap this once, and that'll do it for the first half of play.
So we come upon halftime here at Soldier Field with the Bears out in front. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thank you very much. We'll get back to you and Charles in just a minute. Week two of the preseason is upon us. Each team now with just one more game after this one, and then we will get it all started as we normally do on the first Thursday after Labor Day. Meanwhile, for the Bears, we check out their numbers on the ground as they'll try to keep the momentum going into the second half.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Expect to see a good number of backups going forward as we are back and underway here in preseason week two. And this return will net positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. The Raider offense ready to go here to start the third quarter. This offense, Charles, had a strong. First and 10, Burns. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Fresh out of the locker room, they hit him with a gain of over 20.
Oh, that was a nice job there. Quarterback and receiver reading the pressure that was brought. They both knew it was going to open up the middle of the field. Nice little shake and bake at the line of scrimmage, got right into his route. And the quarterback hit him in stride, and he was able to run free after the catch.
First down, Burns. Quick throw, knocked away, and incomplete. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. On second down, here's a run from Haskins. And he's going to take this down close to a first down at about the Bears' 44. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. Running for it, Haskins. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been four down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, so if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
Another run for Haskins. Oh, he's got some breathing room. A little juke. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
This is a little bit like baseball here. Strong up the middle. Both sides want to be that. In this case, the offense ended up winning the ultimate battle.
And those big runs between the tackles, that's a little deflating for a defense, isn't it?
It really is, because that's where your strength's supposed to be. You're supposed to be in a spot where they can't make that yardage there. You're supposed to send them outside. Not in this case.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Parker. And the Raiders are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Straight ahead, here's Haskins. And a few little style points on the juke, but not much room to maneuver after that. They'll try to pound it in with Ricard. And he's in! Touchdown, Raiders! It's a 1 yard touchdown run, and the Raiders have cut it back within a score. Well, they had their chances in the first half, you remember, but had to settle for 2 field goals. This time, they come away with 6.
I think they actually got affirmation about what they were doing by getting a touchdown, because the field goals means they got in range, but couldn't quite finish it off. This time, they broke through, and that's great for the old confidence.
And on the sideline, difference of a feeling between 3 and 6, is it astronomical or no?
It can be at times, that's for sure. A lot of times, the field goal feels like a disappointment. The touchdown, well, that tells you you're getting it done.
And now the pressure gets there, and he goes down. So he couldn't get rid of the football, and that deficit stays right where it is. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25. So here are the Bears now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. Here's the backup now, the former Badger, Melvin Gordon. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Man, I just love being in this stadium. So much history, tradition, so many great teams and games. And we're seeing a pretty good one right now, hotly contested in the third quarter.
And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. Now it's the backup, Winston.
And that nearly the pick that they needed. He couldn't pull it in, though, and it's fourth down.
And that's a really good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the three and out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
That'll be a 50-yard punt with 8 on the return.
And it'll be Raiders football first and 10. Here's Las Vegas ready to take the field. Haskins with a run to begin the drive.
And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26. To throw on second down, Burns. So just 3 yards on the completion there. And now third down and 6 to go.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
The Bears bring out an extra defender in the secondary now for third down. Operating from the gun, Burns. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete. Here's A.J. Cole now as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. It'll go as a 42, make it a 43-yard punt. 6 on the return, and the Bears take over. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. On first and 10, Winston. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. He's going to be out of bounds on what's going to wind up being the final play of quarter number 3. 3 quarters have come and gone. You're watching preseason football on EA Sports. Back now at Soldier Field. It's Bears football here. They also have the lead as well as we begin quarter number 4.
Winston's throw complete there to Johnson.
First target, first catch, and a first down. They'll run on first down with Singletary.
And he maneuvers up the middle for 3, and it's second down.
The last run got 3. Now here's second and 7. Winston. That's caught by the big tight end, O.J. Howard. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to. Pick up a first down.
They go play action. Winston on the move to his left. And he'll just get rid of it.
Offense was moving him a little bit, had him back on their heels, but they earned a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before they're backed up even further.
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted.
And the Raiders are right back in this football game.
When I saw the pressure coming at him, that just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it, and the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of a guy, and can he step into a throw? And when you can't do that, oftentimes interceptions result.
Now the Raiders offense, they get set to head back on the field. The interception sets them up with an opportunity to erase.
They go play action here on first down.
And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down. A give to Haskins up the middle. 44 yards rushing for him now to this point.
That's a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and four. Back to throw. Burns.
Check down complete to Haskins.
And the broken tackle helps lead to a first down gain. 4 yards on the pickup. Good enough to extend the drive.
That's just what you call a chain mover right there. Nothing fancy. Get the ball out to the back, and you're asking him to make a little bit extra out of maybe what is nothing. And he does exactly that, picks up the first down. I can't wait till we get to the point, partner, where we're not saying chain mover, but we're saying laser pointer picks it up for the first down.
Throwing on first down, Burns. And a quick throw here, that's complete.
On the move past the 40.
And he will go out right near the 35-yard line.
That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and we watch him drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 35-yard line. Looking to throw. Burns. Pressure, and he's taken down. A Bear sack. Jalen Smith. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him. And you hate to say it with a rookie quarterback. He's done some good things, but overall, looked a little bit overwhelmed back there, hasn't he?
He certainly has. But in his defense, he hadn't had a lot of time to throw the football. You like the way I said that? In his defense.
In his defense. I got it.
Yeah. See what I did there?
Yeah. He needs better protection, that's for sure. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Operating from the gun. Burns. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call.
Offense.
They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. Back to throw. Burns. And this is incomplete. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Looking to throw. Burns. And he fires one, but incomplete.
So now here in the second week of the preseason, you'd expect the starters play a little bit more than they did in week one, but not a whole lot.
So if you're an offensive coordinator, what are you looking for?
What you're looking for is things getting cleaned up as you go along, because most of your playbook's probably installed. How well are they handling it? Easy in and out of the huddle? No mental mistakes? Are they starting to look like a good offensive football team?
Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. So the failure to convert, no doubt, really hurts. But this one's not over. A good chunk of time on the clock and the timeouts.
Yeah, not only do they have the timeouts, as you just noted, they're going to get an extra one with the two-minute warning. And that's going to help them big way. So in a sense, they have 4 timeouts in their pocket. The big thing, stopping them on defense now. They can't let them get a first down and make them use their timeouts and get a fresh set of downs. They've got to stop them right here. And if so, they've still got an opportunity.
And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. A good pickup, 17 yards and a bare first down. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. They'll keep it on the ground. This time it's Gordon to about the 26 here. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go.
And remember, no overtime here in preseason. This offense hoping that's a moot issue as they try to finish this one off.
On second down, here's a run with Singletary. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of three. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. They'll try and run for this with Singletary. Oh, no, he lost the football. And the offense will get this one back. Boy, that could have been catastrophic at this late stage of the game, but they avoid disaster. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. And they take a knee. Second and 11 now. A give up the middle to Singletary. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. Play number 7 coming on this drive. It's 3rd and inches. Winston goes ahead, takes the knee, and that should be all she wrote. So this one in the win column for the Chicago Bears. And it was a bit of a strange game. They were held scoreless through the entire second half, but their first half output, that's enough to carry them to victory.
And that's an odd game to watch, isn't it? Because when we saw the output in the first half, you think to yourself, okay, they've got something working here. They know what they're doing. They'll continue that along. But instead, it's goose eggs in the second half. Fortunately, enough of a cushion and enough.
Allegiant Stadium. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
And here come the Saints for their opening drive. And a look at a guy, definitely got a little razzle-dazzle to him. Can do it with his arm or his legs, their mobile QB.
And what an incredible athlete with a cannon for an arm. And he's drawing comparisons to some of the best mobile QBs the league has ever seen. In addition, this is a young man who's learned.
Willis going to look to throw first play.
This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two.
On second down, a run with ETN.
6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
It's a play fake, here's Willis.
It's caught by Mike Evans. A good gain on first has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29.
And this is Shepard on the jet sweep. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, I sure wouldn't be surprised if we see more of this as this game goes on, because we know they like to use their wideouts either on quick throws or on jet sweeps like what we just saw there. And to say that that one worked well, partner, that's stating the obvious.
So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory at the 49-yard line.
ETN up the middle.
And he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up.
Following the pickup of 4, here's second and 6. To throw, here's Willis. And they're going to get this down to about the 37.
That's an early scramble that can be viewed positively by either side. From the offensive point of view, it begins to establish it as a possibility to keep it on certain plays. And defensively, they avoid giving up a huge play in one of their first tests in containing a quarterback on the run.
On first and 10, it's ETN.
And he'll snag about 5 yards down to the 32.
Now they'll look to Willis to throw.
Flushed out, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Out of the huddle now for play number 9 on this drive. This is third down and 8.
Third down, it's Willis. They'll try and set up the screen to ETN.
And a good tackle there right around the 30. Stops him short of the first down. He did his best to just get 4 out of that, but not enough. And now fourth down.
I wonder what was going through his mind when he got the play call. He just got sacked on the previous play. He knows they're coming after him again. A little bit of guts to stand in there, take the hit, and successfully complete the screen pass. Really well done.
Sanders' kick is good, and the Saints are going to take a 3-0 lead.
So they'll likely get a few more drives before we see the second team, but a good start for the first unit with 3 points.
Yeah, good start, and now they want to see them build on it, because you're exactly right. They'll get a few more drives at this stage of the preseason. Can they continue to evolve and add to what we just saw in the first drive?
and makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line.
So now it's the Raiders' turn to go on offense for the first time. And they will be led out by the youngster, the rookie, their QB.
We're seeing it more and more in this league, how teams love to have athletes back there taking the snaps, guys who can throw it and move around and get yards with their legs if needed. He's one of the best examples that we see out there right now. He can throw.
First carry now for Kareem Hunt. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Hunt.
And he'll be stopped up at the 26 after a gain of only a couple.
He was brought down at the 26. A 2-yard pickup.
On third down, Burns got his man, Robbie Anderson.
And he's going to have the Raiders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Second quarter from Vegas, the homestanding Raiders with a football here. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. On first and 10, Burns eluding the pressure right.
And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line.
Brandon, you know more about quarterbacks protecting themselves, but I have to admit it. I liked what I just saw there. That rookie wasn't afraid of absorbing a big hit. Now, you don't want to see him taking those shots all game long, but he picked up the first down, kept fighting for yards, and was willing to embrace some contact to keep the play moving.
So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 46. Back to throw, Burns.
That's taken in by the tight end, Josiah DeGuara. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up second down.
They'll run with Hunt on second down. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better fit than running right through a tackle. He's able to get the center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
First down, Burns. And he's going to go down here, a sack. They push him back to the 34. Handoff up the middle, Hunt. And he'll get a little over 2, maybe a full 3 down to the 32-yard line.
He's brought down by Deion Jones. A 2-yard pickup.
To throw on third down, Burns. Flush to his right, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Cameron Jordan in there to get him for a loss of 9 yards, and that also leads to fourth down.
Partner, you know what I'm going to say before I even say it.
Yeah, you just cannot take a sack in that spot.
You're exactly right. You can't take a sack in that spot. Potentially now, a 3-point swing right there.
So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for 3, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. And I tell you what, he got it from 58. That had lots of leg behind him, and that will tie us at 3-3. So matching field goals on our opening 2 drives.
Yeah, it feels like 2 boxers feeling each other out here in the early going of the game, right? Exchanging some jabs, but none of the heavy stuff just yet.
And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25.
New Orleans Saints, they get ready to set up shop for their second drive. And after the field goal last time, see what they can.
first down, Willis.
Toward the sideline, and that is a nice catch as he's able to tiptoe his way out of bounds. Second and six, just inside the 30.
Second down throw coming by Willis.
That's going to be caught by Josh Reynolds. First target, first catch, and a first down.
A gain of seven, and the Saints first down.
Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete. Here's second and 10 now from the 35.
Willis will look to pass again here.
Over the, and it's a fumble. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line. A lot of talk this week about ball security. In fact, they added an extra period in practice to be more secure with the ball. It didn't work out there.
Well, sometimes you just get overexcited during the game. You may all of a sudden make your catch, see some open field, and decide you're going for it, and not realizing the danger.
Following the fumble recovery, Burns. And this is going to be incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Throwing again, Burns.
He'll find Aguara complete.
And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. On third and two, Burns. Open man is Anderson.
And he's brought down here just outside of the 20.
Gotta say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and 10.
And this one caught along the sideline, but they say already out of bounds. And the throw didn't give him a chance to turn it upfield, and that brings up second down. Again, he'll drop the throw.
That one to Swain, complete.
And he is out of bounds, looks like right at the 15.
It's a gain of six.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. This will be caught at about the three. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop him with just over a minute to go before halftime. A kicker fest so far, all points via field goals. They're hoping to change that right here. They'll try to run with Hunt. Stops short, down at the one. Had the broken tackle, but couldn't get it all the way home. Second and goal from the one. They run again with Hunt. And he is not going to get in as the big bodies stop him at the one. He'll try to run for the first down with Hunt. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the five. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. Now Justin Tucker's out to try the field goal. From the left hash, a chip shot here. Tucker's kick is good. And they will take the lead here in this battle of field goals at 6-3.
So the defense are able to force their first turnover of the game, and then they add on to that by getting the field goal.
And you don't just want to take the ball away from your opponent, partner. You want to make them hurt as well. And if you don't score yourself on defense, turn it over to your offense and have them put points on the board.
And this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25. The Saints offense going to head out now late in this first half. And with
we'll
Willis looking to throw on first down.
And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down. Throwing again on second and 10.
Willis.
And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a halt. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half.
They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains. On third down, it's Willis.
And down he goes, brought down a Raider sack. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. On fourth down, ready to punt, Michael Dixon. So a change. They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. So if you like field goals, this is your game. 6-3, three field goals at the break. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, thank you very much. Week 3 of the preseason is here. Everyone wrapping up their exhibition schedule. No games for the league on Labor Day weekend. And then it all begins. The 17-game regular season gets underway on the Thursday after Labor Day with the NFL kickoff game. Meanwhile, for the Raiders, we check out their numbers on the ground as they'll try to keep the momentum going into the second half.
All right, Coach, thanks. Yeah, both teams likely to make some changes in what's been a closely fought battle to this point. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30.
Now comes the Raiders offense. They'll go on offense first to start quarter number 3.
And they've got the lead.
They'll start the third quarter on the ground with Hunt. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3.
On second down, right back to Hunt. And he'll push forward for a couple to the 34.
With the middle linebacker to 4-3, so often the captain of the defense gets them all lined up, and the captain made a great read there to snuff that play out.
And sometimes all of your best laid plans of play design, your X's and O's, they can't always account for individual effort defensively. And this was one of those times. Just a terrific play to hustle over there and get the running back to the ground.
Looking to throw. Burns escaping the press. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Thrown back across his body.
And the Saints are going to take possession of the football.
That is a tough way to start the third quarter. You get the football, hoping to drive it down, put it in the end zone, and take the lead. Instead, they give them the football.
And I think the key here is for them to not get discouraged. That is not how they drew it up, not how they saw it in their minds. But there's a long way to go in this game. You know, they've just got to find a way to come back one play at a time. Yes, it's a cliche, but they can get it done.
Now the attention turns to the Saints offense getting ready for death.
Straight ahead, ETN.
And nothing much materializing. Throwing on second and 8.
Willis
toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete.
Well, good field position to start the drive, but under the gun now here on third and 8. Willis will look to throw it. Slant complete to ETN. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
But they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Now Willis on first and 10.
And it's caught. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover. And they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there. And now they're looking at a first and goal.
Might we see our first touchdown of the game? Here's first and goal.
ETN is not going to get back to the line of scrimmage as they'll tackle him at the 3.
It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
So they're backed up to the 3-yard line, second and goal. That's going to go down as a loss of 5, and it brings up third down.
And now third and goal coming up, the loss on second down. That just means this crowd's going to get even louder, and they'll get a little bit of extra help from the defenders as they exhort them to join them in the effort.
And back at the 8 now, third and goal.
Willis on third and goal.
He's got it. Touchdown, Saints. Mike Evans from 8 yards out.
And the Saints have taken the lead here in this third quarter. So a very strong first drive in the second half, Charles, as they've turned that halftime deficit into a third quarter lead.
And they were pretty purposeful there, weren't they? Measured in their approach. But boy, they executed awfully well moving the ball down the field.
Jason Sanders now for the extra point. And he's got it as the lead is now 10-6. So this drive spans 7 plays.
And it's Mike Evans who caps it with a touchdown reception. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone.
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
Las Vegas' offense back out there ready to go. And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive.
Throwing on first down, Burns. And that is incomplete here.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10.
Out of the gun, they run it with Hunt. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage.
Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains.
On third down, Burns. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Marcus Davenport, the first rounder out of UTSA with a sack.
Well, third and long, you knew that he was going to throw it. He just couldn't find anybody to throw it to.
Yeah, and it shouldn't have been a surprise, but that was perfect execution of their nickel defense. That fifth defensive back, the extra defender, he really tightened up things downfield and coverage, and they were able to get to him in the pocket.
Here's A.J. Cole now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. That'll be a 44-yard boot, just a yard on the return as he's covered up quickly. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10.
New Orleans offense back. Now ETN to start the drive. And he'll be pretty well stopped in his tracks. Give him a yard up to the 42.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9.
The shotgun snap to Willis.
Flushed out right. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little
too far. It brings up third down.
And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
And here's Dixon to punt now as he gets this one away.
And that one hits at the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback.
The Raiders offense ready to go.
And really, Charles, not much of a surprise that they're...
On first and 10, Burns. Throw left side complete. That's Anderson. And he'll go down at the 26, following a gain of 6.
Now a timeout here, at least for the moment. Looks like one of the Saints is injured, shaken up on that last play.
Well, you hate to see this before the regular season even begins. And we'll take a break and come back. More preseason action in a moment.
From the 26, they'll line up on 2nd and 4. Back to throw. Burns. Catch is made by Hunter Renfro. And they're able to get this one across the 35. That one will go as a gain of 11. Raiders having a first down as well. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more preseason football on EA Sports. Back now in Las Vegas. Welcome back, everybody. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. It's Raider football here, but they're on the short side of the scoreboard right now as we begin the 4th. And he can only manage to get a couple. 2nd and 8 coming up. The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. A first throw for the backup, Ryan. Open receiver here, complete. It's Parker. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. That one good for 37 yards.
Well, this is where an offense needs to show what it's made of. And, in fact, where a quarterback needs to show what he's made of, trying to engineer a fourth quarter comeback. And he hits a big one right there.
Haskins now on 1st and 10.
And he swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage.
So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10.
No gain on the play. Brings up 2nd and 10.
Looking to throw. Burns. And a throw right sideline is complete. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3. A well-executed 22-yard gain.
Mix of play calling so far. 3 runs, 3 passes. All 3 passes have been completions. 1st and goal.
I think on defense now, you have to almost take a chance. Rely on your scouting. Pick a play you think they would run here and just load up for it and see what happens.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on 1st and goal.
Haskins fighting, but he won't get too far. Maybe a yard, that's all. Down to the 2.
Taken down.
2nd and goal, here's an option play left. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. It's their quarterback scoring on the 2-yard keeper.
And the Raiders put together a 4th-quarter drive to take the lead.
We saw so much of this last year at the college level, but there you go, his first rushing touchdown as an NFL quarterback.
And with the speed he has, we certainly know it won't be his last, because that's something that aided him very well, as you mentioned, at the college level. It's something he's going to carry over, and they'll make it a big part of their offense.
Now an important extra point here to stretch this lead to a field goal. He's got it, and this is indeed up to a 3-point lead. So an 8-play drive covering 80 yards.
touchdown.
And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. The New Orleans offense set to take over. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown. Their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. And the Raiders have got him. So they will take the sack instead of the penalty.
And it takes another down off the series. But the biggest one of all, do you want to tell the guy who just got the sack that it no longer counts?
No.
No, not at all.
And they'll get him down here at the 23. On third down, he'll drop to throw.
This pass complete, he finds Jeremy Rucker.
And a good job defensively. They stop him short of the first at the 32. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And it'll be fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. Fair catch called for and made right at the 25-yard line. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return. And the Raiders will take over now, first and 10.
This drive starts with a Haskins carry.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So it's Raider football as we get you reset. This, in all probability, another run here on second and 8.
Second down, and they go back to Haskins.
Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame.
And remember, no overtime here in preseason. This offense hoping that's a moot issue as they try to finish this one off.
Going to throw right side here, complete. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number 2. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10.
A handoff, Haskins trying to right side.
And he's going to take this across the 50 and into Saints territory. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
Second down, and they go back to Haskins.
And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation. And taking care of the football, paramount, and he got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball. The Raiders likely going to get out of this with a victory as they take a knee. Down to a knee one more time, and that should just about do it.
So this one, a victory for the Las Vegas Raiders.
And they were spurred on by a strong performance in that fourth quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game, but when you throw one in the fourth quarter, that tells everyone that you're getting stronger. And dominance is starting to take over, right? The way that you close, the way that you finish, that gets preached to you from the time you're playing Little League football all the way up through. And they closed them out with a big-time performance down the stretch.